Welcome to HHIM Church, where we are connecting the heart of man to the heart of God, with Drs. Jerome and Tonia Taylor.
Hello, everyone. This is Bishop Jerome A. Taylor, and thank you for tuning in to the Connecting the World to HHIM broadcast. I pray that these broadcasts have been a tremendous blessing to you and your family's life. I want to thank my MeTV family for tuning in every Monday at 3:30 p.m. Hey, look, get on the phone, call someone, tag someone, email, hashtag, do all those social media things, and let them know that Connecting the World to HHIM broadcast is on the air. Look, sit back and relax because we're getting ready to go to a service that's already in progress. Your people, thank you for this day that you've assembled us to hear the words of life, the words of truth. We thank you, Father, that the entrance of your words gives life and light and understanding to the simple. Now we lean to Holy Spirit, who is our great teacher and our great God. It's his responsibility to lead and guide us into all the truth. I thank you, Father, for thinking through my mind. I thank you for speaking through my lips. And I thank you, Father, that I will carefully and precisely articulate the words that you press upon my heart to feed these your precious people. Now, Father, I thank you that my body is strong, my mind is alert in such a way that fresh revelation knowledge will flow freely today, unhindered, unchecked by any demonic forces. And we thank you, Father, for allowing us to enter into new dimensions of faith, power, and authority, and our lives will never be the same as a result of what we're about to hear. Now, Father, thank you, Father, not only do we hear your words, but we're great applicators and doers of the word of God. Now, we give you all the power, the praise, and the admonition in advance for what you shall accomplish in and through our lives today. For it is in the matchless, majestic, and mighty name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I need about three happy people to shout amen.
Amen.
High five your neighbor. Thank you for coming to church again. You may be seated. Amen, amen, amen. Bless the name of Jesus. You know, we got, Pop, how old are you going to be next week, 2 weeks? How old are you going to be, sir?
80.
And he's been with me from almost day one. Not day one quite, but like, you know, from the beginning. And so how many of you are older than 80? Mother, you old? She older than 80? How old is mother? 86. So, 86 and 80. So, you know I don't want to hear no excuse from nobody else. They set the bar, right? They came to church on their own. You drove here that? Okay. So, you set the bar for folks. I don't want to hear no excuse from y'all. You know. See, that's the kind of stuff get us in trouble with God. 86-year-old and 80-year-old.
Amen.
And they ain't got no excuses to hear. So anyway, I'm gonna let that sink and Selah, let that sit in your mind for a minute. I love y'all. No, we can't be giving God all kind of excuses. Because if your life is gonna arrive to the place of destiny, then you can't give yourself all kind of lame excuses why you can't do what you need to do for God. All right? You're on a mission for God, and you don't have all day to do it. Okay? Time is, I mean, they understand, they get, you know, and I thank God, long life will he give to them, to mom and dad here. But I want us to be excited and not give God all kind of excuses why we can't get with him and serve him, a part of being obedient to do what you need to do. I mean, I don't feel like a lot of stuff like you do. You know, the world's ran by people who don't feel like it. That's why we take products back 50 times. Because people don't feel like it. But we got to be of the generation that feels like it. We got to be of the generation when they said unto me, let us go. See, I didn't get pumped when I got here. When they said, let us go, I was already excited to get here. Amen. We got to get excited. Show a little more excitement towards the things of the kingdom. God woke you up this morning. I didn't wake you up. He woke you up. You know what I mean? He woke you up. He gave you life and breath and strength. That's something to praise him for. Some of us let the devil, right, rob our praise. Right, we get up in the morning, we start complaining about everything else we got to do, and we got 20 things in our mind instead of just giving God worship. Just like, woke me up. My alarm was a confirmation that the angel touched me. So, bless God. That's not what I'm talking about. Let's talk about this. 15 things you need to know about obedience. Let's go. Clip one. Let's just go and jump into this. Number one, you got your paper. Let's continue to write. Now, what I'm going to do, I'm have some scripture references that I've already given you, so I want you to write these down to the side. That's number one point is obedience will always bring blessings into my life. All right? Obedience. Come on, say that out loud. always will always what bring blessings into my life. All right. So anytime you obey God, it always going to yield blessings into my life. Who does not want to be blessed? Amen. I'm a fiend for God's blessings. I want to be blessed. I don't like terrible things happening to my life or nobody's life, really. I grew up in a whole lot of drama on the east side of Jacksonville, and I grew up just having a lot of bad things happen in my community. And so I didn't like it. You know, I had no control of it. Of course, I was not saved, so I didn't know how to stop it. And so when I came into the kingdom of God, got myself, when the Lord saved me, I didn't save myself. When he saved me, I just really enjoy him blessing me. Amen. I just like good things happening. How many know what I'm talking about? I like good things happening to you, to us. Amen, for God's people. So obedience will always bring a blessing in my life. Number two, let's keep moving. I'm gonna get some points in today. I know some of y'all said, Bishop, we're gonna get no points in. I'm gonna get me some points in today. Let's read out loud. Obedience will always position me to win in every situation. Now, I know some of you in here don't like competition, but I know some of you are very competitive. And how many like winning? When you play a game, you cannot stand to lose. Raise your hands. Some of you are very competitive. You like winning. But also connected to that, we would say not piggyback, but cowback. The cowback on that thought, God wants you to win in every situation. Amen. God is not interested in you losing. All right, he's not interested in you losing. I want to take you to a scripture because I know some of you said, well, Bishop, give me all the stuff. I have no scripture references. I'm going to give you a scripture reference. All right, let's go to Proverbs real quick. I'm going to take you to a quick scripture. I just want to hit the scripture and show you something real quick. Proverbs 13. And if you have a Bible, if you need a Bible, please raise your hands. If you don't, the ushers will assist you. If you need a Bible, just raise your hands. All right, Proverbs 13, 15. I'm going to read for the sake of time, okay? Chapter 13, and verse number 15. It says this: good understanding giveth favor, but the way of a transgressor is hard. The way of a transgressor is hard. Look up real quick. I know you're looking at it. The way of a transgressor is hard. A transgressor is someone who breaks God's laws. Lawlessness. A person that who does not want to listen to what God has to say. When you say life is hard, I'm a question. Or look at you and ask you, are you lawless? Because life for you as a believer shouldn't be hard. Now, we're going to have some challenging moments, but it shouldn't be hard. We're going to have some challenging moments. Many of the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord shall deliver them out. We're going to have some challenges. Doesn't exempt us from challenges. But if you're a believer, your life shouldn't be hard. It says the way of a transgressor is hard. Why? Because they're lawless. They don't want to follow nobody. They don't want to listen. And you know, my mom said back in the days, a hard head. I never understood that. You need to give that to some people in the gym. Amen. All these people trying to work on different parts of their body. Tell them just keep being hard head, making the gluteus maximum soft or whatever. Okay, so if you make your bed, you got to sleep in it. But all of that pertains to people that's being what? Lawless. You want to do your own thing? So you don't want to listen to me. Everybody got somebody we need to. I got this thing, right? I believe this. Who in your life, whose position in your life, when they speak, you're going to stop and do it? You trust their leadership that say something to you, that you'll stop and make it happen or make the necessary adjustments in your life. Now, I've done this now. I'm being honest with you. I don't want to be the smartest people in my, I don't want to be the smartest person in my circle. I'm accountable to my man of God, which is way brilliant than I am, and also one of my mentors who's brilliant. Come on, I give these guys credit. They know more, and I submit myself to their leadership, so if they speak a word to me, I'm going to make a correction. That's just me personally. I want somebody in my life who, when they speak, I know they have my best interest at heart, and if they say something, I'm going to make the necessary adjustments. I don't want to lead myself. That's dangerous. Let me say that again. I don't want to lead myself. Some of you doing you too much. You leading yourself and nobody, you have nobody you're accountable to. And sometimes life can be hard because you don't want to listen. Amen. See, in the word listen is the word list. Some of you want God to answer your list of wishes. And until you start listening, He not even consider your little list. Yeah, so we got a laundry list to give to God. God, bless me here. Bless my children. Bless my family. Bless, bless, bless. He said, "Now, but you ain't listening. But you're presenting a list to me." And it's like with your kids. Don't even bring me no list if you ain't what? Listening. You know, we got children to help us understand how God feels about us. That's what your children position in your life. They help give you a revelation how God feels about you. And you know how you feel about them. Hello, everyone. This is Bishop Jerome Taylor.
And I'm Dr. Tonia Aiken Taylor.
Hey, look, I'm here on the set with my girl to bring you some very exciting news about the fire and glory services that's going to be going down right here, 104 Behrman Street, in the beautiful town of Moncks Corner, South Carolina.
Who is this King of Glory? He is the Lord strong and mighty, the Lord mighty in battle. I'm telling you, the Fire and Glory Conference is going to be a conference like no other.
Honey, I'm so excited about this time of refreshing and refilling.
And refilling. You know, we've been really busy.
Yes.
And had, well, we say busy, but very productive with a whole bunch of wonderful stuff going on. So this is going to be a time to recapture, recapitulate, refill, refuel, refire. And it is going to be a dynamic time. Why don't you tell us who is coming?
Well, honey, of course, we have none other than Apostle Louis Greenup.
All right. Yes.
That's my dude. Apostle Louis Greenup.
Yes.
All the way, of course, from Baton Rouge, Louisiana.
Louisiana.
Honey, look here. This man of God, if you've never heard the Love Doctor, he is also called the Love Doctor, of course.
Yes.
Now officially he's called the Apostle of Love. We are going to have him right here in our beautiful town, in the town of Moncks Corner, South Carolina. And, honey, we're going to be dealing with some various topics. He's coming here to celebrate with us as well. But, again, it's called the Fire and Glory, a time of refreshing and refilling.
Yes.
Those dates are going to take place April 23rd through the 30th. That's right, April 23rd through the 30th of 2017.
Yes.
And, of course, honey, we're going to be kicking off at Sunday, April 23rd at 11 o'clock a.m., and we have that service called
It's
All About Him.
Him.
And the second service is going to be taking place on Tuesday, April 25th at 7:30 p.m., y'all, and it's called The Encouragement for Sticking with the Vision.
That's
honey, we've
right.
had our wonderful church family, community family.
Yes.
We've had a lot of people to stick with this vision
Absolutely.
For over 18-plus years.
That's right. You know, and I don't know if a lot of people know that right now we're in the middle of a stop it campaign.
Wow.
We're going to stop it.
Wow.
We're going to pay this mortgage off.
Yes.
It is almost done. And so we've been working. We've been on the grind, and we've been making it happen. And so this conference is just going to be a time of refreshing and refilling for all of our labor and what's been going on.
That's amazing. Honey, also on Wednesday, April 26th at 7:30 p.m., hey, it's parents and students. If you're a parent, if you need some parenting things, you need to know something about
tips,
parenting, you need to be encouraged
wisdom.
As a parent. You know, honey, parenting is not for cowards.
No,
I'm telling you what,
it takes
tough love to raise babies in
Absolutely.
This day and time.
That's
so he's
right.
going to really speak to the parents. Yeah. He's going to minister also to the babies, the student. We call it a parent and students night.
Yes.
And, of course, everyone is welcome.
Absolutely.
The next service is going to be Thursday night, April 27th at 7:30 p.m. He's going to be dealing with leaders.
Yes.
Hey, look, if you are a leader in the community, if you're leading something, someone, you need to be right here at 104 Behrman Street in the beautiful town of Moncks Corner, honey.
That's right.
This man is anointed.
Yes, he is.
He's been on the stage with Bishop T.D. Jakes, Manpower. He's also been in the presence, of course, of the great bishop, Paul Morton.
Yes.
Matter of fact, he actually laid hands on Paul Morton's wife, and she was filled with the Holy Spirit back in the days, I think, before Paul, Paul Morton married his wife. So Apostle has been all over on big platforms, small platforms, and we're excited that he's going to be on this platform.
Absolutely, because we need him here in the Southland.
Yes,
yes,
so that's going to be dealing with at 7:30. Again, April 27th to 7:30 p.m. on leadership.
Mm-hmm.
Also that Friday night, my Lord, Friday night, honey, April 28th. Could you say April 28th?
April 28th.
Could you say 7:30 p.m.?
7:30 p.m.
He's going to be dealing with relationships.
Lord, the Love Doctor
Lord,
is
have
coming
mercy.
Out.
Lord, have mercy. Now, look, if you need some help on any type of relationship, now, the Love Doctor is raw.
Yes.
And he's going to be dealing with relationships on that
Friday
night at 7:30
yes.
p.m. You don't want to miss it. Look, the answers are coming. I believe God has answers that's coming to the community, absolutely, coming to our personal lives. Mm-hmm. Hey, we have areas where you can get it. I wish that you'll come all the services, honestly. But we know some of you may pick what you want to do. Look, it's also on the website. Look on the website, www.himcity.org. And these service times, of course, will be there. But look here, he ain't finished because of that Friday night. He's going to be dealing with relationships from singles to the married to all over the place. So that's right. Going to be quite exciting. And of course, honey, he's going to close us out
on that Sunday.
On that Sunday, mm-hmm. April the 30th at 11 o'clock a.m., one service only. Mm-hmm. And we're calling that Let Your Glory Fill this place. Lord, have mercy.
Let your glory fill
Woo!
This place.
Girl, you better stop it. I'm telling you, honey. Right, it's going to be going down like four flat tires right here.
Oh,
104 Behrman Street, yes. Moncks Corner, South Carolina, 29461.
I tell you what, we're looking forward to having you here in the house. It is going to be absolutely phenomenal. Mm. And the Spirit of God is already moving. So we're not just waiting for him to come and to unleash all this on us. We're already in a flow. We're already teaching on worship.
Yes.
We're already moving into a place in God. So we are excited. So come on down, because I believe there's some things that only worship can get us through and get us out. Mm. And then we're going to end the month on a high note with Apostle Lewis Greenup,
yes,
as he comes in and talks about the fire and glory.
Hey, look, you don't want to miss none of these services. Again, hit us up on the World Wide Web, www.himcity.org. All the information is there. Of course, you can text 54244 to HHIM. Look, all that is on our mobile web. If you want to also donate, like my wife said, we are in the momentum to paying our facility up.
Yes.
Long story short, we started at $1 million, y'all. We're down to $58,000. That's right. We're down to $58,000.
Yeah.
And you can text 54244 to HHIM. And you can also know that that's the way you need to do that on the mobile web.
Okay. And so let's say it again. That's
text
H-H-I-M
to 54244. Yes.
All right. Very
and
good.
And it's at the bottom.
And it's also at the bottom
of your screen. Yes, yes.
So maybe you're out there tonight. You're saying, look, only $58,000? I think I'm going to write that check. And you can either do it on the app.
Yes.
Or if you want to put it in the mail the old-fashioned way, you can send it to P.O. Yep. Or P.O. Box 1938, Moncks Corner, South Carolina. I think we better send it that way.
Yeah. We're getting all excited.
So, yes, exactly. So that's P.O. Box 1938, Moncks Corner, South Carolina, 29461. But whatever you choose to do, it will be a blessing to push the vision forward. And you'll, of course, get to see us do more with the children, more with our seniors. Just continue to engage more in our community. So we want to thank God for those of you that have helped us throughout the years and who's going to continue to help us as we move forward.
Hey, we love you here at Heart to
yes,
Heart.
We do.
Love you here at the HHIM Church. And remember these words, Acts chapter 17, verse number 28. For in him we live and move
and have our being.
And by the way, it's all about him. You'll kung fu fight somebody for them babies. Amen. Come on, you Incredible Hulk turn green. All of us got a marvel in us. I don't know what your marvel is. But when you get mad, somebody, a marvel coming out of you. One of the writers said, there's a king in you. No, there's a marvel in you. And that thing will come out. Come on, somebody push the right buttons. But you know, the Lord gave me a thought, and we're going to get off of this. I want you to hear this thought here. He told me, he said, it's not your job to figure it out, but it's just your job to obey. So many times our mind's trying to figure out the will of God, figure out the plan what God wants to do. Remember this. I always say this, and I say it, and you can see to the corner. God can see around the corner. You got to give him that honor that you know more than me. I know some of you got your master's, your PhDs. You got two PhDs, five of them, but God's still smarter than you. You got to give him that. You got to give him his props. That he's smarter than me, and I really want to trust my life to his leading. Amen. Not try to figure, because your mind will try to do some stuff, man, that, you know, some of you are breathing. Well, how is this going to work? I don't understand. This just doesn't make logic. Well, you got to learn to live your life not by logic, but by the Spirit of God. Amen. Number three, let's keep moving. Number three, obedience will also trigger this part. If you don't do it for nobody, do it for them babies. Generational blessings. I know you've heard a lot about the generational curses, but obedience will also trigger generational blessings. Let's set up the next generation. If you don't do it for you, then I know you'll do it for them babies. I don't need my next generation to experience havoc because I didn't obey God. Come on, because generational curses or blessings hit the second and third and the fourth generation. And they're going to hit it based on your decisions today. Amen. What are you going to do today to set your family up? Outside of the natural, you should do that too. You should have a will. You should be having some stuff. You should have a nice insurance policy. You know, quarter of a million, half of a million. No, but you too concerned about a cell phone. You got two of them. Three, excuse me, and a beeper. Beeper done went out. You got three cell phones and a beeper. You know beeper's done played out. But nobody's trying to set up. I'm going to do. No, we need to set the next generation up. Amen. Something happens to you, who's going to get set up? I'm just out here talking. You may not have a whole lot of money to put in the bank for them right now, but if something happened to you, can the generation say, man, boy, daddy was a good man. My mom was a good woman. Because now your life is speaking from the grave and pushing them forward. And insurance policies ain't that deep either. But you ain't think about that because you ain't think about the next generation. You got you on the mind doing you. We need to learn obedience will trigger what? Generational blessings. How many interested in generational blessings? Wow. I pray that that word ministered life to right where you are. You know, there's times where we just need a word from the Lord, and I pray that that lesson minister to you right where you are. Hey, look, we never want to leave our broadcast without giving you an opportunity to receive the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior. Hey, look, if you would bow your heads right where you are right now and repeat this prayer after me. Say, dear God in heaven, I acknowledge that I'm a sinner, and I acknowledge that I'm in need of a Savior. I repent of all my sins, and I accept Jesus Christ into my heart as Lord and Savior. I am sincere with this prayer, and this is my request to the Heavenly Father. I accept Him into my heart as my personal Lord and Savior. Hey, look, if you prayed that prayer, welcome to the family of God. The heaven is applauding you. We're applauding you for the newfound relationship that you found in our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Hey, I'm excited. There should be information at the bottom of your screen, a website, www.himcity.org. If you would text, hit us up, email us, or let us know that you just accepted the Lord Jesus Christ, we want to send you out some free information about this newfound relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ. Hey, congratulations, and again, welcome to the family of God. So we never want to leave our broadcast without, again, giving you a shout-out. Hey, look, remember these words from Acts chapter 17, verse number 28. For Him we live and move and have our very being. And by the way, it's all about Him.
Good afternoon, MeTV family and friends, and thank you for tuning in. You asked, how can you partner with Heart to Heart International Ministries? And I have an answer. You can text HHIM to 54244. Right here on the grounds of Heart to Heart International Ministries, we have done a free summer camp for 3 weeks where parents had an outlet. And now our basketball court where the youth will have an outlet. Right here on the grounds of Heart to Heart International Ministries. My business partners, you've asked, how can I partner with what the ministry is doing? Thank you so much for asking. Text HHIM to 54244. If you need more information, visit us at himcity.org. That's himcity.org. We appreciate your interest, we appreciate your support, and we appreciate your continued support. So join us as we move, as we are led by God, because our vision is connecting the heart of man to the heart of God. So text HHIM 54244 right here to support and be a partner with Heart to Heart. Thank you, and we love you.
HHIM Church proudly brings to you Fire and Glory, a time of refreshing and refilling with Apostle Dr. Louis Greenham, a.k.a. The Love Doctor. April 23rd through the 30th, April 23rd, 11 a.m. only. It's all about Him. Tuesday, April 25th, 7:30 p.m., encouragement for sticking with the vision. Wednesday, April 26th, 7:30 p.m., parents and students. Thursday, April 27th, 7:30 p.m., leadership. Friday, April 28th, 7:30 p.m., relationships. And concluding Sunday, April 30th, 11 a.m. only, let your glory fill this place. Heart to Heart International Ministries, HHIM Church, 104 Behrman Street, Moncks Corner, South Carolina, 29461, 843-899-0877, www.himcity.org. Host pastors Bishop Jerome and Tonia Taylor. Fire and Glory, a time of refreshing and refilling with Apostle Dr. Louis Greenup, a.k.a. The Love Doctor, April 23rd through the 30th, 2017. You don't want to miss this time of refreshing and, of course, refilling. HHIM Church is on the go with our mobile website. Use your mobile device and stay connected with us anywhere, anytime. Text HHIM to 54244. That's HHIM to 54244. Click the link and welcome to HHIM Church. Scroll down to the Stay Connected tab and please enter your information. Mobile number, name, email. By doing this, you will be alerted with all the information to our special events and services designed to get you to the heart of God. HHIM Church on the go. We're using technology as we are connecting the heart of man to the heart of God. You are welcome to attend any and all of our services. Sunday morning fast food services, 8:30 a.m. to 9:30 a.m. Sunday morning, 11 a.m. worship experience. Tuesday night Bible experience, 7:30 p.m. Thursday corporate prayer, 7 to 8 p.m. We would love to see you here. The HHIM Church is here for you. Every third Sunday, celebrate with us as we celebrate Family and Friends Day at the Heart. Start the day off right with our fast food service, 8:30 a.m. to 9:30 a.m. Or join us for our morning worship experience, 11 a.m. Two services to choose from, both offering the power of the Word and the love of Jesus in a mighty way. Every third Sunday, Family and Friends Day at the Heart. HHIM Church, 104 Behrman Street, Moncks Corner, South Carolina, 29461, www.himcity.org. Family and Friends Day at the Heart. Celebrate with us and enjoy a free meal. Free meal giveaways on every third Sunday. This is your invite. Join us for our Family and Friends Day at the Heart every third Sunday. The HHIM Church is here for you as we are connecting the heart of man to the heart of God.
Live it up, live it up, live it up.
Broadcast. Join us next week for another dynamic worship experience from the heart. This is HHIM Church.